Welcome to Steam Deck 101. I mean, who doesn't want to take this class? That's right, our order finally came in and we finally have it in our hands to go over all of the ins and outs and even make a weekly series out of it for all the new things that are happening on the Steam Deck. And yes, believe it or not, there's that much stuff about this device. This is going to be a fairly lengthy video. I mean, any 101 class is. So we have a syllabus, like a walkthrough of sorts. So make sure you check out the links in the description below or that cool YouTube chapter thing that's down at the bottom to jump around to the various sections. Now, before we go more into that, let's look at the deck and all the ins and outs right here on Robeytech. Handheld gaming systems are way more prevalent today than they've ever been. And it's funny enough, there's some you may not have ever heard of, but we have covered even here on the channel. Things like the One X Player, which you can check out our review of right here. We have the Aya Neo, and of course the Nintendo Switch, the Switch Lite, and the Switch OLED, which used to be like one of my favorite gaming systems. Now the Steam Deck brings a little different flavor to all that. It's made by Valve, and they aim to do it right and give you access to your entire Steam library in a meaningful handheld way. Well, I use entire Steam library in quotes because it's not entirely true. Oh, and by the way, it even has a Linux desktop mode to boot for all you Linux lovers or people who just want to learn Linux. Actually, believe it or not, this is a little handy device for that. Now, the Steam Deck has three different versions, and each one comes with more storage than the prior and extra goodies on top of that, like custom cases like the one that we have here. It's different for each Steam Deck. Now, at the time of this review, there was initial region availability at Valve has put on their site over at SteamDeck.com to state that the Steam Deck is only shipping currently to the US, Canada, Japan, welcome everybody, konnichiwa, the EU, and the UK. Now, more regions are to come per their site, so make sure you follow over at SteamDeck.com or follow Valve over on Twitter. Let's go back to the deck, okay? The first one there's the 64 gigabyte deck that retails for $399.99. It comes with 64 gigabytes of eMMC internal storage and a carrying case. There's a 256 gigabyte version of the deck that retails for $529, and with that you get 256 gig NVMe for faster storage than the eMMC, a carrying case, and an exclusive Steam community profile bundle. Finally, you have the 512 gig version, and this is the version that we're gonna be going over today. This one retails at $649.99, which is a steal, by the way. All of these prices are crazy, and in fact, Valve is actually losing money on the deck just to make sure it gets into your hands. It's got a 512 gigabyte PCIe NVMe SSD and an upgraded display, giving you a premium anti-glare etched glass display and an exclusive Valve branded carrying case, ba-ba-bam, and an exclusive Steam Community profile bundle and an exclusive virtual keyboard theme for the deck. And we'll talk more about those themes later on. One thing to note, the 2230 M.2 drive is not intended for end user replacement. Now I know, just recently there's been stories about Steam Deck and Steam specifically saying, hey, we want you to have right to repair on this thing, but honestly, that doesn't mean right to upgrade. Like Linus did with like the giant grips and like the extra heat sinks, and it's not even fun to carry anymore. It just doesn't look that good. But you know, hey, Linus has got his tastes and we've got ours. So all models include a plug and a charger along with a micro SD slot for additional storage capacity like this SanDisk Extreme. You know, they have great sizes and this expands the storage by quite a bit. Now the deck sits at about 12 inches long, which is about 2.5 inch longer than the Switch. It's about 4.5 inches tall, which is about 0.5 inches taller than the Switch, and by 2 inches deep, which is about 1.5 inches thicker than the Nintendo Switch. It's also a lot heavier too, weighing about 1.5 pounds, where the Switch comes in at just under 1 pound with the Joy-Con controllers attached. Now, before we jump into the innards of the deck and what powers it, let's look at the buttons and the ports on it. We see a power button, a status LED light for the deck is on or charging, a USB Type-C port that is for charging, for audio and for video out. There's a headphone jack, there's a plus and minus volume individual buttons. It's not just a volume rocker like what you would get like on an iPad. And you also have an L1 and R2 bumpers and L2 and R2 analog triggers as well. Now moving to the front of the deck, we have the gorgeous 7-inch IPS LCD touchscreen with a mic pinhole on the upper left and upper right of the screen. Noticeable, but it's built into the hardware itself and not the screen. You have your thumbsticks in L3 and R3, a view button along with a directional pad. Over on the right side of the front, we have the menu button along with the diamond-shaped A, B, X, Y buttons. We see that the deck has a left and right trackpad for use in desktop mode or even in some games. Now, there's also a left and right speaker. And finally, there are two buttons that you will more than likely just love. The first is the Steam button on the left side of the front. Where the Steam button is pressed, you have the option of Home, taking you to the Steam homepage, your library, the Steam store, friends and chat, media, downloads, general settings, and of course, power. Think of this as swiping down from the top of your iPhone or just from the top down on your Android phone to access all the quick access settings. Now, from within the battery icon in the quick access menu, you can select the basic to advanced view to show that overlay in the upper left that shows things like CPU percentage, GPU percentage, frames per second, and you can go nuts and even see what each thread is actually doing on the CPU by turning it all the way up. Now, we still think that this should have been labeled not performance overlay 4, but performance overlay 11. I don't know, kind of a nod to some of the stuff that Tesla does, because it like unlocks like the Spinal Tap version of the overlay. As for the quick access menu, that's kind of what we're gonna cover for now. We may go in depth later at a later time with another video, depending on if changes happen or whatever. But if you'd like to see more, let us know down in the comments below. So let's talk about the internal specs. This thing is powered by an AMD Zen 4 4-core 8-thread CPU, an RDNA 2 AMD APU. Comes with 16 gigabytes of LPDDR5 RAM. The display on the deck is a 1280 by 800 IPS LCD that is 7 inches diagonal with a 16 by 10 aspect ratio and a 60 hertz refresh rate. The colors pop and the games look just as good as they do on a bigger monitor, which, I mean, you can always use a bigger monitor, but I would recommend doing it on a separate PC. The display does get bright. It comes in at 400 nits of brightness, and you may want to turn down the brightness if you're playing in the dark. Now, there is also a night mode in the software quick settings you can turn on if you want to choose to play in the dark and actually not hurt your eyes and get so much blue light, because it's like blue is bad. The deck also supports Bluetooth 5.0 for controllers such as your Xbox Series X or S controller, various accessories such as Bluetooth keyboards and mice, along with portable Bluetooth speakers. You can like walk around with this like on your belt and like one of those like big boombox Bluetooth speakers. The deck also supports a bevy of Wi-Fi connections. There's no AX support here for Wi-Fi 6 or the AX connection, which would have been nice, but we expect that's something that maybe comes in Steam Deck 2.0 model. Now, we did mention there's a USB-C port on the top. Now, this supports USB-C charging, but it also is a DisplayPort 1.4 alt mode, which can do up to 8K at 60 hertz or 4K at 120 hertz. I don't know why you would run that kind of resolution off of something like this. This is definitely not powerful enough for it, but hey, if you wanna go crazy and you're one of those guys, like we talked about earlier, then there you go. There is going to be a Steam Deck docking station that you can purchase in the future that props up the deck while connected to like external displays, and it offers things like wired networking. And you can add that to your Steam wish list right now, and we'll have a link to that down in the description below. And boom, that is a rundown of all of the specs on the Steam Deck. Now let's jump into the different modes now on the deck. We have two different modes. We have a gaming mode, and then we have what's called a desktop mode. And these are the modes that are available when you actually turn this thing on. Gaming mode is what you're seeing from like these screenshots or these video captures, which is like your typical Steam client with options to like go to the store, your library, and another fun feature, which I absolutely love, called Great on Deck. This gives you titles in the store or in your library that are certified to work on the Steam Deck, and the titles have passed all the compatibility checks, and each one Valve says is a great experience for it. If you're seeing a screen like this, this means that the game will not function on the Steam Deck as of right now. Now, we're pretty sad that Fall Guys isn't supported, as it would be a perfect game to play on the Steam Deck. You also come across messages like this. This means that while it's playable, you may have to divert to some of those Steam shortcut menus to figure out different button combos to perform interactions within the game. To access storage in this mode, press the Steam button and then go to Settings and then Storage. From here, if you have an SD card installed, you will see that you can even make it the default. Now, the latest version of the Steam OS is version 3.2. There are options to switch from a stable OS channel to a beta channel. And the beta channel brings some cool new features in which we will discuss in future videos, as this overview is just about the Steam Deck itself, and there is a ton to go through. But we want to make sure that you're properly up to speed and ready to go when we add new information to our Steam Deck classes. Now, before we get out of the whole gaming mode, let's talk about battery life. Now, we've tested a few games at different brightnesses. We found that the average battery life can go up to as high as 9 hours. But those more intense games, like for instance, Elden Ring or Cyberpunk, and especially if you play for long sessions, obviously the battery life is going to go down from there. If you're on a plane flying from New York to Seattle or from Detroit to LA, the Steam Deck battery life should last you pretty much all flight, as long as you turn down the brightness, as that seems to be one of the biggest drains on the deck. Capping the frame rate at 30 frames per second down from 60 also seems to have a pretty significant impact on the battery life for your Steam Deck. So another Nice pro tip. So those are some great features in the gaming mode, Robey, but you mentioned there's a desktop mode running Linux. What's that all about? First, let's do a little background on Linux, as it is one of the most popular platforms on the planet. Linux has been around since the mid-1990s and has since reached a user base that spans the entire globe. Linux is actually pretty much everywhere. It's on your phone, it's on your thermostats, it's in your car, it's in your refrigerators, it's on your Roku devices, in your televisions. It also runs most of the internet, all the world's top 500 supercomputers, and the world's stock exchanges. Now, the version you have on your deck is not a supercomputer. It's a simple and easy to use desktop environment. Now, it comes with Firefox already pre-installed. It has a mail client in Thunderbird pre-installed, and everything you would need off the bat to use it the way you would use something like Windows. It actually looks very Windows-ish. Now, we're not gonna go into like the functions of the Linux portion today, but just know that there are options available. And we would love to hear down in the comments below if you would like to see more coverage from us on Steam Deck and Linux use. We have covered a lot, and I'm sorry if it felt a bit dry, but we wanted to get as much information into the Steam Deck 101 as we possibly could. We covered like the ins and outs. We covered the features, the functions, the options. We showed you some of the games and how they run and how to see how the games run using the different performance mode and overlay options within this. We talked about Linux, but it's not about what we think. We'd love to know what you think. Did this overview help you? Would you like to see more overviews like this on other devices like the Steam Deck? We'd love to know that, so leave a comment down below with your thoughts. Now, here at Robeytech, we plan on releasing new videos on the Steam Deck pretty regularly. So if you have any ideas for future videos, we'd love to know what those are and sound off down in the comments below. Oh, and as a bonus, if you tell us your thoughts, then you could also win a little cash in the process. First and foremost, you need to leave a quality comment down below along with liking and subscribing to the channel. Now, when I say quality comment, it doesn't need to be positive. It just needs to be something you liked or didn't like about, you know, the Steam Deck or the video in general. Just not, I deserve to win, can I have your free Steam Deck, or something else weird or lame. You also need to have a way for us to reach you via your YouTube profile, like your email. So put your email in your YouTube profile, because we will be giving away $25 to one lucky comment below that is worldwide, as long as you can accept PayPal or Venmo. Now, if you don't have an email in your YouTube profile, we can't tell you you've won, and therefore you can't win. So what did you think about the Steam Deck? Are you surprised by any of the functionality? Are you still waiting for yours? Are you considering ordering one now? We'd love to know all that and more down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so you get a notification each and every time we post a new video right here on Robeytech. Did you know we have a live stream channel for special builds and events? Yes, sure, we're not going to be building this, but if you want to, check out Robeytech Live down in the description below so you can like and subscribe and know we're gonna do other awesome builds that aren't the Steam Deck. Because yeah, this is already built. Now, do you have questions about this case or any other tech-related questions, then check out our amazing Discord server over at discord.gg/robeytech, filled with other tech and PC enthusiasts that love to share their thoughts and ideas on these very subjects. Are you looking for cheap tech? Then check out @robeytech.com or @robeytechdeals on Twitter. We have our guy Tom scouring the internet for the best deals on all things from tech to PC components to TVs when he's not covering the Steam Deck in general. Now, finally, you can follow me and all of my team on all of the other socials at Robeytech absolutely everywhere. We hope you really enjoy this video, and we look forward to seeing you on one of many of our mini Steam Tech videos here very soon.